What's up, game developers? CouchFerret here, and today we'll continue our archery game with an aiming mechanism. We'll create a crosshair and move it around with the right joystick. If it sounds fun, then stay with me and consider subscribing so you won't miss any future videos of this game. Cool, let's begin. I've already made a small pixelated crosshair. Its opacity is 50%, so we can partially see through it. We need to import it and set its parameters in the inspector. Now, let's drag it to the scene to get one copy of it. In the hierarchy window, we have to drag the crosshair onto Keith to make it to Keith's child object. The crosshair now lives in a different coordinate system, which is centered around Keith. If we reset its X and Y position, then it moves to Keith. With this trick, it's enough to set its position relative to Keith, so we don't need to set it globally, and when Keith moves, the crosshair will move with him. Let's create the new inputs for aiming. I use Rewired, which is an input system asset, instead of Unity's input manager. We need to create two new actions, aim horizontal and aim vertical. We have to set both of their types to axis. Let's go to the joystick maps and map them to the right joystick. Aim horizontal is right stick X and aim vertical is right stick Y. Now the two new inputs are ready to use from code. First, let's rename our movement script to player controller because from now on it will handle aiming as well. Let's open it up and rename the class in it too, otherwise the script won't work. To access the crosshair game object, we need to declare a public variable for it. Let's save the script and fill the variable in the inspector window. Let's define a separate function for moving the crosshair and name it moveCrosshair. To execute the function the same way as the character movement, we have to call it in the update function. Let's make a variable with a vector-free type to store our current aiming direction. To only move the crosshair when we aim with the joystick, we need to create an if statement and check its size. The if statement's conditions should be aim.magnitude greater than 0. I've planned an aiming mechanism which only represents the aim direction and not the exact position where we want to shoot. To have the crosshair move around the player while we aim, we need to normalize the aim vector. The vector normalization will make a vector 1 unit long, so the crosshair can only be 1 unit away from Keith, not less or not more. This will give us a nice circular motion. Let's test it. Not bad. But I think the distance between Keith and the crosshair is a bit too big. To have it closer to Keith, we have to multiply the vector, let's say, by 0.4. That's much better. However, it's a bit odd that the crosshair remains visible when we don't aim at all. To make it disappear, we need to disable it when we don't aim, but let's not forget to enable it when we do aim. We can achieve this by extending our if statement with an else part and typing crosshair.setActive false into it. To enable it next time, we have to type crosshair.setActive true to the if part. It looks perfect now and it also follows our archer wherever he runs. That's it for today, folks. Saturday, we will continue with our script to shoot arrows. We will instantiate arrows from a prefab and give them velocity to move towards the enemy. So be sure to subscribe and leave a thumbs up. If you have any questions from today, feel free to ask and I try to answer all of them. See you next time!